Recently, thanks to my employer Loudly, I went to DroidCon Berlin 2022. During a conference, a lot of attention was given to modern Android app architecture and the now standard Android UI framework called Jetpack Compose. This inspired me to write a synthesizer app for Android using all the cutting-edge technologies of Android. Over a series of tutorial videos, I will guide you how to build such an app using the best modern Android development practices. Hi everyone, this is Jan Wilczek from thewolfsound.com, and if you're new to this channel, here you can learn how to process sound using self-written software. And indeed, in this tutorial series, we are going to process some sound. The main goal of this tutorial is to build a wavetable synthesizer Android app. The secondary goal, however, is to use the newest Android tools and practices. What will you learn in this tutorial? You will learn how wavetable synthesis can be implemented in an app. You will learn Kotlin basics in a fun and easy way. We'll also touch on Kotlin coroutines. You will learn the Android development basics, the Jetpack Compose basics, how to interface Kotlin with C++ code, how to control audio output on Android with the Oboe library, and finally, how to implement the modern Android architecture guidelines. And all this in a single tutorial. So if you are a C++ developer who wants to learn how to interface with Android audio-wise and UI-wise, or an Android developer who wants to learn how to build music apps using modern technologies, I invite you to watch this tutorial. In this episode, I will quickly show you the architecture of our app, Android architecture guidelines from Google divide Android apps into three layers. The UI layer for dealing only with what the user sees, the domain layer for business code, and the data layer, which deals with data persistence, access to a database, and so on. This architecture, however, is not very useful for music apps, as I am a keen student of George R.R. Martin's Robert C. Martin's clean architecture. I prefer the ports and adapters approach to architecture. Let's abstract out the details as much as possible. Here you can see the architecture of our app. At the very top, we have the UI layer built in Jetpack Compose. The UI layer sends events to and observes the state of the view model layer, which also holds the UI state. So whenever a user presses a button, the UI layer sends an event to the view model. The view model passes the changes to the app core logic, updates the UI state, and this update is observed by the UI layer, which updates its controls. The view model does not know that the UI exists at all. Finally, on the Kotlin side, there is a class that represents our synthesizer. As you can see, we made it an interface to be able to fake it for testing and debugging purposes. The main activity class holds references to the UI layer, to the view model, and to the wavetable synthesizer instance. It is okay because the main activity is regarded as a dirty module that is very concrete because it initializes everything. The native wavetable synthesizer class connects via Java native interface to the C++ code. The C++ code is similar to what we have written for the wavetable synthesizer VST plugin, but it's not the same. As you can see, the synthesizer interacts with the Android audio device. I abstracted out this interaction as well so that it can be replaced later. I used the Oboe library to connect to Android's audio because it's the recommended way to do things related to audio on Android as of 2022. Please keep in mind that this architecture evolved over time. It's not something that had been written in stone and hadn't changed since the project inception. And so we reached the end of our architectural part. Here you can see the list of technologies I will be using. You can check out the full source code on my GitHub at any time. The link to it, along with the link to the article describing the synthesizer, and the link to the VST wavetable synthesizer tutorial I did, you can find in the description below the video. And if you want to know which areas of knowledge you need to master to write sound processing software, check out my Ultimate Audio Plugin Developer Checklist, which you can get for free at thewolfsound.com/checklist. Don't forget to like, subscribe and turn on notifications. In this way, you'll be notified when the next episode of this tutorial goes live. And in my opinion, it's worth it because it'll be about building the whole UI of our app using Jetpack Compose. So, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Take care.